President Trump won the 2016 election in large part due to razor-tight wins in critical battleground states, one of them Wisconsin. Hillary Clinton never campaigned there, but in 2020, the Democrats planned to hold an entire convention there until COVID changed all that. Yet the fact remains this election will be fought and won by how these swing state voters feel about the president or Joe Biden. Mary Bruce spoke with several of them to hear what's on their mind.
In a state Trump won by less than a point in 2016, the range of opinions over brunch at Frank's Diner in downtown Kenosha make it clear Wisconsin could again be a battleground that determines the race.
Definitely going to vote for Biden.
Probably going to have to say Trump.
Neither the Republican nor the Democratic candidates really appealed to me.
In 2016, Trump took Kenosha by a mere 238 votes. Swing counties like this propelled him to take Wisconsin by a razor-thin margin. But not all voters are standing by their previous decision.
The ballot wasn't even cold in the box, and I'd already regretted it.
Lori McCammon tells us in 2016, she was drawn to Trump's hardliner stance on immigration.
I thought maybe he could do better in Washington not being a career politician.
I can tell that you seem pained by this.
I am. I feel that he is chipping away at our democracy, and he's doing it in plain sight. And I really am. I'm very fearful that if he's elected again, I don't know if this country will ever recover from another 4 years of him.
You said that in hindsight, you wish you had just left your ballot blank 4 years ago. Is that your intention in November, or will you be voting for Joe Biden?
Oh, no, I'm voting for Joe Biden. I have voted on Republican for most of my adult life. I don't know if I will ever vote Republican again.
Trump is also having to defend his stronghold with rural voters, including more than 7,000 dairy farmers who have been hit hard by falling milk prices and the trade war with China. Lynn Hicks has a small family farm in Gilman, Wisconsin.
I'm a small guy. I'm just a drip in the pail.
You don't feel like Washington is listening?
I'm not a huge farm. I'm not a huge business. I'm not a huge anything, but yet I'm here day in and day out, and right now I don't feel that that's necessarily appreciated.
She tells us come November, she may sit out entirely, though she is a fan of the president's tough talk.
He's not going to take any crap. He's gonna say, nope, this is the way it is. This is what we need to do.
Do you think Joe Biden is capable of that same kind of tough talk?
I don't necessarily know.
The Kyle family is concerned about economic uncertainty for their dairy farm.
This is a job, but it's also our livelihood. You know, we're putting a lot of money, sweat, and tears into what we do.
But they're standing by President Trump and how he's handling the economic crisis.
There's some things about Trump I absolutely love and other things that, you know, I'm not crazy about, but I think Biden's a nice enough guy and everything, but it's kind of hard to not see that he's moving his policies more radically left.
Of course, Wisconsin isn't all farmland, and turnout in its major cities and among young, diverse voters could help determine who wins the White House.
I think it's important to realize Wisconsin is kind of a powerhouse. We can go one or either way.
Melena Moore and Ayanna Elzey are young activists in Milwaukee.
You know, black and brown people have been targeted for years, so I would love to see justice.
They plan to vote Democrat in November, even if they're not that enthusiastic about the Biden-Harris ticket.
Biden is a means to an end for some people. I definitely feel like, getting Trump out of office is the number one priority.
One recent poll shows Biden up in Wisconsin by 5 points, but experts say the state could go either way.
My sense is that Wisconsin will continue to be very, very close.
Prominent Wisconsin commentator Charlie Sykes says this election could largely come down to Democrats' ability to turn out the vote, especially as Trump ramps up his baseless attacks on mail-in voting. In April's primary, in-person voters were met with long lines like these. Nearly 1.3 million absentee ballots were delivered to voters. Nearly 90% of them returned and counted.
Is there a danger, you think, that the president's concerns about mail-in voting may actually backfire on him?
I'm hearing that from Republicans, that they're concerned that Donald Trump's attack on mail-in voting might actually suppress his own base, because Republicans in Wisconsin have been using mail-in voting for many years.
One of those Trump supporters who has been voting by mail, Aaron Decker, the GOP chair in Kenosha County.
I actually absentee vote all the time.
Are you concerned at all that you know, the way the president is talking about mail-in voting, that it may discourage some people from voting by mail?
I know that some people naturally are leery of it. There's just people out there that they want to stick that ballot in that machine and make sure that they hear it beep.
Meanwhile, Democrats are trying to defend Biden's lead without directly connecting with voters on the ground, a challenge now that Biden's convention in Milwaukee has gone virtual.
We're disappointed, obviously, that Joe Biden is not going to be in Milwaukee next week to accept the nomination, but I've heard nobody upset or angry about it. We've got some time before the election, so we're hoping that, you know, Joe Biden and Kamala Harris are going to be able to come to Wisconsin.
Lori Hawkins, the Democratic chair, says she believes the coronavirus will be the key factor for most voters.
It's affecting pretty much every aspect of people's lives. And what we're hearing is that they are unhappy with the response that Donald Trump has brought to the pandemic. They're saying that, you know, it didn't have to get this bad.
Mary Bruce, ABC News, Washington.
Our thanks to Mary Bruce.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.